out when I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball. Play like every day. For all the time, nobody helped me, said I ball.
Well, we're about a $50 cab ride away from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. A few moments ago, the crowd here was on their feet as their beloved Jets made their way out of the tunnel. They're ready to go. We're ready to go. And it should be a good one as those New York Jets get set to face off with the New England Patriots. Get strapped in. It's just about time to get the party started. And we are underway here on EA Sports. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. First carry now for Dalvin Cook. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now.
And Charles, you think about what this defense has had to prepare for. They're in for a battle. I mean, they're facing a team that is working on a six-game winning streak.
And that can be intimidating when you think about it in those terms. But I think what they need to do is make some sort of a statement early in this game, whether it's a turnover, a takeaway, a key sack on third down, a three and out. Something lets the other guys know that you mean business. Figuratively, throw the first punch and make it a good one.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. That's going to set him back 5 yards. And now after the delay of game, they're operating behind the stick, second and 15. From the gun, it's Wilson. Here's Johnson with a reception. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Give to Cook out of the gun. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4, second and 6.
Well, these two teams hooking up for the second time this year. They first met back in October, week 7, and it was the visitors getting the win there, so they'll be looking for the sweep back here at home.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Now Wilson. Flushed out right. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive game.
Third and 1, Wilson. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Here's the Jets punter now. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. It's just a 32-yard punt with no return. And the Patriots take over. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed, but they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. They'll try the left side. It's Warner, and he'll be brought down right around the 37.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Glove. Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll go deep down the middle. And the defense loses him. It's complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Now the extra point try forthcoming. And he gets it to make it 7-0 Patriots. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The New York offense taking over for their next possession and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again. Good, sure hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he's able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage? They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. Following the good run by Cook, here's another first and 10. Now Wilson. The catch is made by Ellington. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. On first and 10, it's Wilson. That's to Cook out of the backfield. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9.
Boy, how about
the speed with which this offense can get down the field. It's taking them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
Wilson. Got a man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jets. A great effort there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up. So now the Jets are lining up to go for 2. Wilson gonna throw for it. And it's caught. He's got it. So they go for 2 to convert. And along with it, they'll take an 8-7 lead. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This one fielded at the 5. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. At the line, ready to go. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. With these run-pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in 3rd in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be 1st, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
A tight one. 8-7 our score after 1 on EA Sports. Throwing on 2nd and 3. Love. Throwing left side. It's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. So now a fresh set of downs. 1st and 10 after roughing the passer. Here's Love. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. A great play there. His 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots on just 2 plays have taken the lead. Extra point splits the uprights. And that makes this a 14-8 ball game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Here comes Nelson. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. The 40. Past the 20. And they are not going to catch him. He's in. Touchdown, Jets. I know a lot of special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with. And they say, challenge him, kick into him. The way he runs, as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Right side. It's Warner. It's a room to maneuver. And he will finally be taken down at the Jets 24. 68 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
And you talk about great blocking up front. I don't think he was even touched, not a finger on him, until he was brought down to the ground.
I think we heard the whoosh as he went by, didn't we? Right through the gap. No one there, as you outlined, no one touched him at all. A free sprint into the secondary.
Yeah, that's what you call breaking free right there.
Touchdown! A great effort there. His ninth touchdown of the season. And once again, the Patriots are back out in front. Extra point right down the middle. And that'll make this a 6-point game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
He's going to look deep for more. And that's caught inside the 35. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. It's a big play that time by the Jets. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Handoff comes to Cook. Down to the 30 after a gain of 3.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. We'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave them with a third and about 5.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
To throw is Wilson. Being chased out left. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
They'll move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. That's going to be caught. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They'll run for it with Cook, and he is going to lose yardage here. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Second down and goal. Wilson escaping the pressure right to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
On third and goal, Wilson. Flush to his right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get to third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
Fourth down, here's Wilson. And it's incomplete, they cannot convert, and they turn it over. They're turned away on fourth and goal, and the Patriots get the football back. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead, not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Throwing right, and that's complete. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Looking to throw again on second down. Love. And going deep downfield for Boykin. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. This secondary has been roasted in this first half, but they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
Play action this time with Love. And this pass broken up. But the contact well timed there, and now fourth down. The Patriots send out their punter, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. And he was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one hears away. 36 yards on the punt with no return, and control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And with great starting field position up near the 50, they might be one completion away from stealing a late field goal here. Trying to lay one up deep. It's caught inside the 25. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. From the shotgun, Wilson. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field for that one. So the margin shrinks there as they get the field goal to draw them a bit closer here in this second quarter.
Yeah, nice snap, nice hold. They just want to keep this game close, so give them credit for finishing that one off with three.
Fielded right around the eight. Oh, a good return up past the 30. So at halftime, it's the Patriots with the advantage. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
With both of these offenses having their way, it's not likely they'll need to be doing a whole lot at halftime. But the defenses are definitely in need of some adjusting. And for the call of the second half, let's go back out to Brandon and Charles.
Yeah, Coach, certainly no shortage of action in those first two quarters. Definitely got to work on my touchdown calls, so we'll see how much voice I have left for the second half here.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. First down, going to the air with Love. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
Love now to pass on first down. Flushed out right. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, these two teams, you might remember, met in Foxborough earlier in the season with the Patriots winning that ball game. So they're looking for another win here at MetLife Stadium to take the season series 2-0. Here's second and 10. Now Love.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 38-yard line.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw now, here's Love. Eluding the pressure right, and his throw here is incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
With the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Love now. Going for Boykin, but it is intercepted. Picked off by Justin Reed. And the Jets are going to take over at their own 13-yard line.
That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And their defense did its job, forcing the takeaway there to start the half. And now can the offense follow suit?
And you'd better believe that one side of the ball feeds off the work of the other, so they'll want to come out, establish some rhythm, and go down and take the lead.
Throwing again on second down. Wilson caught. It's Ellington.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
On first down, Wilson. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
To throw again on second down, Wilson. And his throw is incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Off the play fake, here's Wilson. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Big Christian Barmore was there on the tackle. Now a second down and six. There's Wilson. And the catch made by Johnson. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. From the gun, it's a give to Cook. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. A good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a three-point game, second and 10. It's Wilson. And that's complete. It's Ellington.
I love the drive they're working out here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively. But they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
Now Wilson on first down. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. A great play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jets have once again taken the lead. Point after, right down the middle. And we'll make this a four-point game. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown.
carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. At the line, ready to go. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate, and of course they'd like to forget the inning, the interception, but they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. Okay, so now the question, how did he get that wide open?
Well, we both know that he shouldn't, because from the time they handed out scouting reports before this game, he was circled, starred, everything. Find him, cover him. But sometimes you can scheme a guy open. You put the receivers in a bunch. Maybe you move some motion. Maybe you put him on the backside of a formation, and all of a sudden you've got a better matchup. Every now and then, the offensive guys, they figure a way to get him open, even with everyone keeping eyes on him.
And that's certainly a guy they want to keep trying to scheme open. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And going deep downfield for Boykin. And that will be incomplete. Try to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
There's a reason the number four was flashing through my mind when he let that one go. Three touchdowns already in his back pocket. The deep ball's been a great weapon for him in this one. Unfortunately, empty on that attempt.
On third down, Love. And the Jets pressure too much. It's down he goes. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Desperation time here. Love on fourth down. To the sideline, and he's got it. They say the feet are down. Yes, the line judge says they're in. That'll be a first down. A big play there for the Patriots. So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Love looking to throw it. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. A great effort there. With touchdown number 15 on the year and second of the game. And the Patriots have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. Extra point splits the uprights, and that gives them a three-point lead. And boy, figure this one out. Leading here in the fourth, and now they're going to try an onside kick. And the Jets have got it. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. They go play action now. Wilson. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Christian Barmore able to record his fifth sack of the season. That's their first time getting to the quarterback, sack number one. And, you know, they had five last week, I'm remembering.
And you have to find a way to slow down the pass rush, not necessarily with just protecting your quarterback, but just show them a lot of different looks. And they did that in the first half, you know, different angles, different things to slow down the speed. They got to him here in the second half. Now they've got to come up with a counter to that and maybe do something different.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that's complete. It's Allington. And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line. Well short of the first. They get 13, but it's not nearly enough. And it'll be fourth down. Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down. He's going to let this one go deep. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive.
And they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. A give. This is Cook, and he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him two on the play. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. For the lead, here's third and goal. Throwing now is Wilson. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Disastrous outcome there on third and goal. They lose 9 yards on the sack. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. And the 10-yard vet knocks it through the goalposts. And that will tie this game here in the final minute of play. So in the final minute, they turn it over to their kicker to get him back to even, and he does not disappoint.
Brandon, do you think the pressure ever gets to this guy? Because I sure don't. That was pretty smooth right there. But I tell you, he better not rest on his laurels, because there's a good chance they may need him again if this game goes to overtime.
The Pats at the line, ready to go.
They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. In a tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. They'll rifle this one deep right side. And got his man complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A big play there for the Patriots. And that'll make it 2nd and 10. And now it all rests on the right foot of their kicker. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. And now this game's going to come down to the right leg of their kicker. This from 55 yards out. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And I tell you, these division games, never for the faint of heart, but they come through with a tight victory here on the road.
And you find yourself working harder in a game like this too, don't you?
Yeah,
because you
got to
stay
sweat.
With it, right? You got to stay with it. You got to stay locked in. It's our type of a game. And you just mentioned it. Division game, on the road, tight, and they find a way to win it. Way to hunker down, as my old coach used to say, and find your way through.
So for the Patriots, they continue to roll as the win gets them to 12-2 on the year. And they'll have another road date next week with the New York Giants. Meanwhile, for the Jets, they'll drop to 10-4 on the year. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Cleveland to take on the Browns.
Eat 'em up. I could do it better than he can.